Thank you for the introduction. I am Marco Caruso. Good afternoon to everybody. I am a PhD student in bioengineering. My PhD activity focuses on the use of a magneto-inertial sensor applied to the analysis of the human movement. So, nowadays, gait analysis is performed in specialized laboratories, and the optical stereophotogrammetry represents the clinical gold standard. Optical stereophotogrammetry measures the three-dimensional trajectories of some markers, optical markers, attached to the body segment. From these measures, it is possible to compute the orientation of the body segment and also the joint kinematics. Joint kinematics is an important branch of gait analysis. In particular, the estimate of the knee flexion extension angle is useful for evaluating some gait alterations, and it is also used in the follow-up of the patients after the surgery. However, stereophotogrammetry doesn't allow to estimate the joint kinematics during patients' free living condition. It requires long time preparation periods, and it also limited the analysis in small volumes. So it may not be indicative of the typical performance in daily life. So what we would like to do is to use the magneto-inertial sensor and to apply it to the field of human movement recording. So magneto-inertial technology has recently broken in the field of human movement analysis, thanks to its key strengths. In particular, this sensor, these are two commercial sensors from two different vendors, are small, light, and allow long time recording periods. Each of these unit integrates a triaxial accelerometer, gyroscope, and magnetometer. The accelerometer measures the vector difference between the body acceleration and the gravity. The gyroscope measures the angular velocity by measuring the Coriolis force. And finally, magnetometer are based on magneto-resistive effect that exploits the Lorentz force. By fusing these measures, it is possible to estimate the orientation of each unit. But to achieve this goal, we need a particular algorithms. The fusion of these measures is carried out within the Kalman filter frameworks. At first, the angular velocity measured by gyroscope is integrated over time to provide a first estimate of the orientation. However, the gyroscope readings are affected by a slow bias whose integration led to an error that grows unbounded over time. To compensate for this error, the complementary information of provided by accelerometer and magnetometer are used. But why is the orientation important? The orientation is important because from the orientation it is possible to compute the relative kinematics. For example, starting from the orientation of two units attached to thigh and shank, it is possible to compute the knee joint kinematics. From this mean waveform, it is possible to assess any gait alteration. More in depth, for each instant of sampling time, the orientation of the thigh sensor and the shank sensor is compute separately. From this information, it is possible to estimate the knee joint flexion extension angle by means of a biomechanical constraint. In fact, the median orientation difference between the two sensor orientation does not yet represent the knee joint kinematics. Now we are going to focus deeply on this procedure. As I previously said, the orientation of the thigh and shank sensor are computed separately, and then the relative orientation difference between them is obtained. Again, this orientation does not yet represent the joint kinematics because, in general, the sensor axes are not aligned with the anatomical axis, as shown in this picture. All the operations are carried out in the quaternion algebra because it is a particular computational efficient representation of orientation. The second step is necessary to obtain the joint kinematics. So we express the previously orientation difference between the two sensors with respect to the starting configuration. In this way, it is possible to align the sensor axis with the anatomical one. The initial configuration is the neutral standing posture. This configuration is defined when the anatomical axis of tibia and femur are aligned, and it is generally acquired prior to the experimental trial. However, the kinematics described in this way occurs in general around the time-variant axis. So the flexion extension angle was then obtained by projecting the joint kinematics onto the plane defined by the mean flexion extension axis. This axis is estimated from the mean angular velocity vector acquired during a functional movement. The projection is carried out with an optimization approach. The experimental session involves one healthy subject that was equipped with two sensors mounted on thigh and shank. The experimental protocol indoor consisted in walking in one direction back and forth at self-selected speed for 1 minute. Reference data were provided by an electrogoniometer mounted on the subject. The experimental protocol outdoor consisted in walking down a sidewalk back and forth at self-selected speed for about 40 seconds. Then the time series of the knee flexion extension angle were segmented and the mean kinematics obtained were compared. So in indoor, the accuracy of this procedure was assessed by comparing the mean value of the two mean kinematics, the one obtained with magneto-inertial sensor and the one obtained by the electrogoniometer. The accuracy was also evaluated in terms of root mean square of the difference between the two mean kinematics without their mean values. Also, the variability of the kinematics during the gait cycles was evaluated in terms of standard deviation on the mean kinematics. So, with respect to the indoor situation, it emerged that the procedure based on magneto-inertial sensor that we called KJE underestimated the mean value. Moreover, the results highlighted that a better accuracy in reconstructing the joint kinematics for KJE. The within the sample variability estimated with this procedure was very close to the physiological variability measured by the electrogoniometer. The performances of the procedures were evaluated also outdoor, but only in terms of within a cycle variability, because the reference data were not available. The variability was closer to the physiological than indoor, and this may be explained by a lower intensity of the ferromagnetic disturbances outdoor with respect than indoor. So, it may be concluded that this procedure provided accurate results, and the variability of the flexion extension angle obtained with this procedure differed from the physiological of about 1 degree. And also this variability decreased outdoor. It is also worth noting that since the sensor and the electroniometers were attached on the skin subject in different locations, different soft tissue artifacts will cause necessarily differences in the final knee kinematics estimation. So, what we would like to do for the future is to apply and test the algorithms for the joint kinematics estimation during patients' everyday life, ranging from the youngest to the elderly, in order to enlarge the possibility of real-time assessment of the human motion. So, now a little focus on our ongoing projects. The first is a Domomea project, is a Sardinian regional project which aims to enable the tele-rehabilitation at home of patients which suffered from a stroke event. The focus consists in executing different rehabilitation exercises in form of exergaming in order to allow a better involvement of patients. To achieve this goal, the project relies mainly on the use of this magneto-inertial sensor, but also other devices such as pressure insoles. The second project, it is called Mobilized. It is an European project in the framework of Horizon 2020. It involves about 40 European partners from about 15 countries. The aim is to design, develop and validate a gold standard tools for the selection of the best device algorithmic pair to be used for the assessment of pathological workers in real-world settings. The project results will facilitate the development of drugs and will provide the guidelines for the implementation of new clinical tools for identifying and monitoring disability. Thank you very much for your attention, and this is our group. Thank you.